the impact on the ratio. And we have two sets of response, response at the macro level by the state and response to the micro level in banks itself. From the state, you have a set of decisions taken by all the states and even in Turkey to help the bank to limit the impact on the ratio. So we have what we call a regulatory flexibility with new guarantees, with adjustment in the requirement around the depreciation, the limitation of the impact on the RWA, the limitation on the impact of EAD. So the states have limited the impact of a crisis by new regulatory requirements, and sometimes they have postponed some tests and some decisions to 21 or perhaps 22. So it is not only, many people have in mind the idea that the central bank are going to give liquidity to banks. No, not only, the state have modified the regulatory requirement actually to support the default risk to maintain the solvency and the liquidity. And you can see here that the regulatory effect now, it's a big effect that the bank have to consider when they manage the company. And you see that on this free ratio, the ratio I have mentioned, all the decisions they have taken have impact on all the dimension of the regulatory ratio. So in fact, the state have no requirement in terms of percentage and so on. They have just changed the way to calculate the ratio. So for me, it's important to do that, of course, but it's a bit artificial. It's a bit artificial, and it is more to show to people that the banks continue to be resilient in this context, not in changing the requirement, but in changing the way you calculate the requirement. So it's a bit particular, but it is what we have now in banks. So this macro level response, in fact, it was necessary clearly, but it is not a specific management of a risk. And my point, and I'm going to finish with that, my point is that we have to develop alternative decision at the level of banks itself. It's the micro level response. At short term, we have already anticipated a high cost of risk. And in the quarterly closing of accounts actually, we anticipate an increase of the total cost of risk in my group, BPCE Group, or Société Générale, for example, in France. We are going to increase the cost of the risk to prepare the year 20, and the year 20 will have a big impact on the cost of the risk. We anticipate twice more, third time more cost of risk in the income statement. We are going to establish scenario to decrease the demand for loan, because the demand for loan is not related now to the investment. The demand for loan is to support the crisis. It's a new demand for us. We are able to treat the demand for investment project, but the demand of loan to avoid the failure is very particular. So we need to adapt our process to that. And what we don't want is to help companies who have already many difficulties before the crisis. And we don't want to save companies at this moment because the crisis happened. So it's a very, very difficult decision to take sometimes to support only the companies who are really impacted by the crisis, and not companies who have troubles naturally. And we have to control very strictly the liquidity, the volatility of the liquidity coverage ratio. And we have to communicate a lot to the board member, to the shareholder, to all the stakeholders of the bank, because on the two, three last months, many CEOs or executive committee have not communicated a lot. They have communicated on general measure about the continuity plan, but not a lot about the financial management of the crisis. So you have actually strict plan to supervise and monitor the liquidity and so on. And I think that we have to think to the midterm. And the idea is to modify and to improve the quality of a stress test, to push the hypothesis to a high limit, because the COVID crisis is the confirm that we have to introduce a very hard scenario in our forecasting, what we have not used to do until today. So we have to think to what it is extreme scenario. It is not because it is difficult that we have to say, no, it's not possible. You have to think to a new risk management, making the effort to better estimate the financial impact. Many times people say, no, it's too difficult to estimate the financial impact. No, we need to estimate the financial impact, even if we have a big standard deviation between the valuation of that. We need to discuss again about the size of our equity, because 10%, less than 10% of equity in the balance sheet, I think it is not enough to face to this kind of risk. 50 years ago, banks have 20, 30% of equity. Now they have less than 10% of equity. I'm not sure it is enough. Even if bankers say, no, we don't need equity. Yes, you need equity to absorb losses. This is the first thing we teach in the course of finance. And in the future for us also, the idea that the behavior for saving from people will be different. So we have to introduce a new risk management inside companies in general, inside banks specifically, of course, combining financial risk and non-financial risk.